the perfect backdrop, rather, for Hollywood films. There's often too much drinking, too much food, and the possibility of a bit of a fight. Just like a date night with Angela Bishop and David Robertson. And they are here this morning with a special Christmas edition of Date Night. Woo! Morning, guys.
Good morning. And the fight was over.
The sweater. But let me tell you, it doesn't breathe. It's plastic. It's awful.
It looks like your aunt with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
I think that would have been preferable.
With a beer?
Under circumstances. Look.
Two beers here.
Yeah,
well, that's not, not there.
Again, I do just want to say once more...
Christmas Day. Merry Christmas.
On behalf of the crew, though, Robbo, thanks again for bringing in your own jumper to work.
Oh, yeah, you're welcome. Yeah, you're welcome.
Well, today is the perfect day to just collapse on the lounge after lunch and watch a movie. And we've got to look at some Christmas movies you may or may not choose to watch. First up is the 2003 romantic comedy Love Actually. This ensemble film has an all-star cast and follows 10 storylines that all show a different aspect of love, with a cast that includes Emma Thompson, Hugh Grant, Alan Rickman and Colin Firth. This is as British as a warm beer and a cold summer. The movie is often described as a modern-day Christmas classic and made more than $200 million at the box office. Here's a look at Bill Nye's character, Billy Mack, who plays a washed-out has-been rock star who's trying to revive his career with the release of a Christmas song.
Welcome back to the airwaves. New Christmas single, cover of Love Is All Around.
Except we've changed the word love to Christmas.
Yes. Is that an important message to you, Bill?
Not really, Mike. Christmas is a time for people with someone they love in their lives.
And that's not you?
That's not me, Michael. When I was young and successful, I was greedy and foolish, and now I'm left with no one, wrinkled and alone.
Wow. Thanks for that, Bill.
For what?
Well, for actually giving a real answer to a question. It doesn't often happen here at Radio Watford, I can tell you.
Ask me anything you like, I'll tell you the truth.
The best shag you ever had?
Britney Spears.
Wow.
No, only kidding. She was rubbish.
Moments in this film. I can watch it and rewatch it and rewatch it. Of course, it's from the brilliant Richard Curtis, who did Four Weddings and a Funeral and Notting Hill. And, you know, not all the love stories work out. We kind of forget that. You think it's this great romantic.
Yes.
I mean, actually, a whole lot of them are really sad.
Yeah.
And, you know, spoiler alert, Alan Rickman and Emma Thompson, that scene,
Joni Mitchell,
it just tears it out. But I have a redeeming moment to bring up, which is a bit of a secret, and I don't know if people know this. Liam Neeson's character, the widow, right?
Yes.
He and Emma Thompson share a lot of scenes. Sometimes you think they're brother and sister, but they're actually just good mates consoling each other through things. When he meets Claudia Schiffer late in the film and you think, oh, he's going to fall in love with the good-looking mum, he calls her Karen, which is Emma Thompson's character's name, not Carol.
Oh.
And the subtext is that he's actually in love with Emma Thompson and that they'll get together after Alan Rickman runs off with the secretary, just putting it out there.
Oh, wow. I
that's
love that.
Deep
and meaningful.
I know, because he's supposed to... Her name was Carol, but he says Karen.
But I thought Emma Thompson and Alan Rickman were staying together for the sake of the kids.
Is that what you thought from the from the airport scene? I don't know. Robbo, what did you think?
I think it's a beautiful display of love and a beautiful display of the testing the boundaries of love, which is what you mentioned there. My boundaries are never tested with you. I love you always. Not you, Tash. But anyway... sorry, Tashi.
Hey, it's
Oh, Merry Christmas. I'm so sorry. Merry Christmas. Come here and give me a big one. Give me a big one.
On a scale of one to Weinstein, that was about a nine.
Yeah, that really was. Sorry about that. I'd give this 5 stars. A beautiful movie. A fantastic. It's a classic. You can look at it all the time. It is 100% beautiful. I was without love for a long time, Angela Bishop, before I met you, and this always gave me hope. I wish that some people would look at me the same way that, I look at you.
Oh. Aww. And after that, I can only say 4 stars too.
Oh, yes. All righty, the next Christmas movie we are looking at is Home Alone, the movie that gave the world Macaulay Culkin. This is the highest-grossing Christmas movie in the US and until 2011 was the highest-grossing action live comedy film around the world until it was beaten by The Hangover Part 2. Now, Home Alone sees 8-year-old Kevin, played by Macaulay, accidentally left at home while his family travelled to Paris. It is the week of Christmas and Kevin is left to fend off a pair of robbers who try to rob what they think is an empty home. Take a look at the two bandits navigating the booby traps that Kevin has left for them. If we could cross live to a 7-year-old David Robinson, he wanted to be that
yes.
Kevin
yes.
for so long. He was the coolest kid around. He just wanted to, like, the booby traps, everything. Who can forget the iconic scene where he puts the aftershave
yes.
on his face? Oh. So I went home and I only could find mum's perfume, so I put a bit of that on my face and it didn't sting. So I was disappointed that both it didn't sting and that I smelled like my mother for a few more weeks after that. But it was nice, though. This movie, like, Macaulay Culkin was fantastic in it. This is really what put him on the map. And I loved it. And I could still watch this, both Home Alone and Home Alone 2, Lost yes. in New York, forget about that. Donald Trump makes a little cameo in the second one. We're not talking about that one today, though, Tash. We're only talking about the first one.
Okay,
so don't
sure.
ask any questions about
all right,
that.
No worries.
What did you think, Ange?
I couldn't stand it. It was written by John Hughes, who wrote so many great movies. He did 16 yeah. Candles, The Breakfast Club, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, and this. Macaulay didn't care. I just thought it was annoying. Mm. I thought it was implausible. Bah Humbug. I give it 2.5 stars.
I'm giving it 4 stars. I thought it classic.
Wow. Well, finally, nothing says Christmas like Bruce Willis taking yes. on a team of terrorists. That's
yes.
right. It's Die Hard.
Yes.
The movie is set on Christmas Eve and we see New York detective John McClane, played by Bruce Willis, head to LA to try to reconcile with his estranged wife and to see his children. He arrives at his wife's office Christmas party to discover that a German terrorist called Hans, played by Alan Rickman, who
no.
needs to be in every good Christmas movie, mm-hmm. has taken the office hostage. This is the first of only 5 Die Hard movies and was released in 1988. Check out some of Die Hard.
With our sad is frightful, dum da dum delightful. For the love.
8 Lincoln 30 to dispatch.
8L30, go ahead.
Yeah, that's a wild goose chase over here at Nakatomi Plaza. Everything here is okay. Over. But nobody has any place to go. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Welcome to the party, pal.
Of course, on Christmas morning, we couldn't play Bruce Willis's other famous line from the film.
I'll say it. If you are KO. No, no, don't
no,
say no, 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 no.
It's best you don't. The jumper's Ooh. Offensive enough. No, look.
Sorry.
That.
You are on fire today, Ange. Tell us what you really think.
Oh, no, that's okay.
Santa been good to you this
Santa's
morning.
Santa's been very good. Santa came in with eggnog at 6 a.m. Look, it's been one of my favourite Christmas movies yeah. for a very long time, rightly so. Everything about it still holds up today. It's
yes.
still a very taut thriller with everything you want in an action comedy, great leads, and Alan Rickman.
Yeah.
It was the first time I'd ever saw it was last night. I'd
oh,
never seen it before. I'd seen number
it.
3 and
That's
number
you,
4.
Christmas Eve. My
and
goodness.
I loved it. It was absolutely amazing. It was Bruce Willis with hair, which is always fun to
always
see.
Good.
And I loved Alan Rickman as Hans Gruber. It's one of the best slow-mo falls in
yes.
cinematic
yeah.
history.
Yes.
It is amazing. Absolutely brilliant. I loved every second of it. Yippee-ki-yay, mother. Yes. Merry Christmas, I meant to say. Yippee-ki-yo, Merry Christmas.
You're going to stumble across
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
word.
I'm
going to
do it. And that is a very Merry Christmas from Date Night.
Four stars.
Four stars.
So,
Both 4 stars for that.
Yes.
Thank you very much. A lot of love in the room this morning, isn't there?
Isn't there? You can feel it.